Hi, this is from Hope 2008, and this is where Mitnick shows you how to unmask caller ID, so when someone calls you and they block their number, you can unblock it. Now what you gotta do is you gotta find, you gotta get an Asterisk box, and you gotta get a SIP trunk provider. And the SIP trunk provider, is a bunch of them out there, but only some of them are enterprise class. The one he's using here is called flowroute.com, and they're different because you can use a credit card and sign up, and they still send privacy information. Now, usually, I guess a lot of companies strip it off, but Flowroute sends everything, and what you got to do is you got to get the information they send, strip out the privacy bits, put it back together again, and you can then forward the number off. All right, so what we're going to do, all right, so here's what he's doing. He's logging into flowroute.com. He's getting a single DID, and then what he does is he uses their configuration generator and copies it into the Asterisk. All right, that normally would work, but now what you got to do is you got to make some modifications. So in a regular call, you usually see the caller ID from the caller, it's in the header, and what's called the P flag, or the P asserted identity, and this is what's used to show the caller ID. So in most cases of a private caller block number, the headers look a little different. The from header is now anonymous, and the privacy flag or field is activated, but what you see is the P asserted identity is still holding on to the caller ID. So here's what you do. The hack is that you take the P asserted identity during private calls and you store it into a variable, and then what you do is you set the header and turn off the privacy flag and forward the call somewhere else. And when you do that, it looks like a normal call. What we're also going to do is we're going to add a little bit of information at the beginning at 900 to show you, or me, that the call was supposed to be private so you don't give it up to the person who's calling you, so you can pretend you just... Anyway, so that's what you do. It's pretty obvious. Just paste it in, restart your Asterisk box, and you're good to go.